I took the morning off from work one day so I could go to court with proof that I had fixed my cracked winch. And according to the officer who pulled me over, at 6:30 in the morning, when I was driving to work, minding my own business, this is illegal. It is against the law to drive with a cracked windshield, and apparently this is every bit as important to the highway patrol as chasing down speeders, drunk drivers, and people abusing the carpool lane. Unlike these offenses, I didn't even know there was a rule against this one. Really? I asked. Other cars zoomed by, speeders, and weaved by, drunkards, as we spoke. They were allowed to continue on to work. I suspected now that he had given me this new and vital tidbit of information, I would be released to do the same. Not so much. I sat on the side of the road for another 10 minutes and counted 6 lone drivers abusing the carpool lane as the officer wrote me a citation. I had a month to get the windshield fixed and show up to court with proof. I signed the citation on the line that said I was fine with this, added a smiley face, and proceeded on to work. I pride myself on being proactive on anything that doesn't involve minor surgery. And in keeping with this philosophy, I replaced the windshield within a week. I called the court to see if I should fax in the citation and proof of replacement, and they told me that I had to show up in court so the judge could see the paperwork and dismiss the ticket. I thought this was an inefficient use of their time and a complete waste of mine, but I held my tongue. After all, this was the law I was dealing with. I scheduled a morning off work so I could go down to the court building with proof that I had done my law-abiding duty. I considered dragging the old cracked windshield in along with the receipt for services, just in case, but wisely considered that they might lock me up in the hoosegow for being a smartass. It's happened before. So, I showed up in the court building bright and early, got scanned for firearms, belts, and car keys, and walked up to the desk marked Information. There was a cute girl and a handsome fellow conversing behind the contemporary curved light wood and metal reception desk, and I stood patient, wondering if my luck was good enough to draw the young lady for my information needs and what my odds were. I had just figured out, using less than one hand, that the odds were 50-50 when the young man turned to me and raised his eyebrows. Damn it, I thought. Foiled again. I have a citation for a cracked windshield and the receipt showing that I've had it replaced. I held these papers aloft for visual backup, withholding the fact that I also had the old cracked windshield in the back of my blazer if he wanted me to bring that in as well.
What court?
I shrugged.
This one?
He looked at me disapprovingly.
It tells you on the citation what court.
I see, I said, unfolding the paper. I looked at it for a couple of minutes, and the young man waited patiently, much as I had earlier. He was excellent at it. I gave up and shrugged again and handed the paper to him. I don't see what you're talking about. He sighed and took the citation from me and pointed to a small line near the bottom with some carbon copy chicken scratch.
Dreamy draw.
He pointed to a line of windows resembling bank teller windows that were stanchioned off.
Lines 6 and 7.
I pondered punching him in the nose for being chippy with me, but I knew how that would end. Thanks, I said. I was taken in line 7 by an attractive young lady, the second I'd seen so far. The day was looking up. I went through the story again, and she took copies of all my stuff. Apparently I didn't need the old windshield, and then she handed me a clipboard. I took the clipboard. Will he do that? Dismiss the fine? I asked.
I don't know. It depends.
Depends on what? I asked. The windshield was cracked. I got it fixed and here's the proof. Can it go either way?
It depends on the circumstances.
I shook my head. Let me put it another way. I'm sure other people have come in and brought in the same proof with the same citation, probably even some earlier this week. Maybe even today, correct? She nodded. And what happened? Did the judge dismiss the fines for these people or make them pay?
It depends.
That doesn't make any sense, I said. It's not like having a cracked windshield is a crime of passion or there was some subjective decision to be made. Window was broken and fixed. If he still makes one guy pay the fine, then we should all pay. And I'll skip filing the paperwork. If the judge dismisses one, he should dismiss them all, regardless of whether he is hungover or angry with his stepchildren, right?
Depends.
Okay. I shrugged again. I didn't even need to see the judge, and now realize that not only could this have been done via fax or mail, but that the decision would probably be an arbitrary one based on nebulous criteria. A colossal waste of time. I filled out the form neatly in case handwriting would come into play.
"Will I need to take another half day off work to come down and see if I need to pay the fine?" I asked. She looked at me as if I were a silly goose. "No, just call us in a couple of days. We'll let you know over the phone." I walked out, resisting the temptation to tip something over and run like hell. Now, as it turned out, I called 2 days later as requested, and the fine had been dismissed. I was one of the lucky ones. The moon must have been in the right cycle, or the judge had been in a good mood, or didn't have a belly full of gas, or had gotten a Hummer in the robe closet. Whatever the reasons, I rejoiced and sped to work the next